about to begin. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the action. It always looked like the kind of track that asks an awful lot of the rear tyres, such as the frequency of low-speed exits.
No matter how good a driver is at managing their throttle application to limit rear slip, they can't always overcome a car that's inherently bad at looking after its rear tyres. Here we have a lot of low-speed corner exits, which means a whole load of energy, heat and tyre wear.
We don't think you'll have any trouble getting into the next session, so don't push too hard.
Thank you.
quiet out on track, we should consider getting out there.
Wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. A Mercedes, Raikkonen and Sebastian Vettel. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway. testing here on Yas Island today through 21 corners and a lap distance of around 3.4 miles. There are plenty of opportunities to pass with long straights and DRS zones in two places, at turns 8 and at turn 11. Plenty of close racing then, plenty of speed and plenty of drama to be found in the laps to come. So as we look ahead to what I hope will be a very entertaining race, I have to ask Anthony Davidson what you expect to see in terms of strategy today. I mean, do you expect a lot of tyre management? A lot of fuel management?
Well, don't we always? I don't expect these are going to be any more important than usual, if I'm honest. What I do expect, however, are a lot of drivers getting into the pits early for some kind of undercut on fresh rubber. If you can pit before the person in front, have a good stop and drive a blistering outlap, there may be 1 or 2 seconds to be gained. If anyone gets stuck behind another car, for example, that will be the go-to strategy, surely.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's Mercedes in pole position then, edging out Raikkonen, who'll start P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Bottas, Max Verstappen, and Alonso, Grosjean, Massa, Kvyat, and Daniel Ricciardo, Magnussen, Ocon, Sebastian Vettel, and Hülkenberg, Palmer, Van Dorn, Marcus Ericsson, and Pascal Wehrlein. Sainz and Lance Stroll rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
It's been a long season, but let's try to end it on a high note.
Thank you.
fastest lap of the race so far. 3 has entered the pit lane. He's in the pits. Thank you. is now open. to our teammate is 29.6 seconds. sensors. distance is 35.9 seconds. Ultrasofts. has opened. Strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. last lap for the race. This lap of the race. Keep this up. There's a gap beginning to form. Exit. Exit now. have won every race this season, this will go down in history as the greatest Formula One season ever.
And Mercedes have pulled off a great victory here today. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres. But at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else. And that's exactly what they had today.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. Our current points leader extends their lead at the top of the championship after a very good result here today. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
It may already be wrapped up, but let's look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.